and see how we're faring on expiry day. We've been in a range of around 35 to 34 odd points, the low point of which has been close to around 8021 and the high point being 8054. So we are somewhere near the high point of the last 40 to 50 minutes. Expiry is expected to be closer to that 8050 level, but we are just marginally buoyed as far as the benchmark is concerned. The movers in today's session, IT stocks are seeing some bit of buoyancy, so Infosys and TCS are the weightage counters that are leading those gains in today's session by a small quantum, of course, 0.8% for Infosys, 15 points by way of that, and TCS is chipping in with 1.2% of gains, 14 to 15 points again by way of that. Axis Bank, HDFC and ICICI Bank, so some of these private financials are also supported in trade. The gains are not exceptional, just under 1% is what we are seeing, but that's keeping the index supported at least marginally higher. ITC is seeing some profit booking after some very strong sessions. So ITC is down around 20 odd points in terms of a Sensex contribution, and so is Larsen & Toubro and something like an Adani Ports, which are marginally weaker in trade. In fact, the advance decline ratio on the Nifty is almost 1:1. So there's no skewness in favor of either in today's session, at least as of now. The second half will be interesting because the writers will throw hook, line and sinker to defend the positions that they have maintained throughout the series. So on the downside, that 8,000 put is a very strong support. 8,050 has seen some heightened activity in the run-up to expiry. We'll watch out for that. Let's pull up the Bank Nifty very quickly. Again, the advance decline ratio on the Bank Nifty is very even. It's almost 1:1 at parity, marginally higher. But the point is that we are still below that 18,000 level, where we are facing some bit of resistance. SBI marginally in the green, ICICI Bank marginally in the green, and HDFC bobbing above and beneath that parity line. So no major moves as far as the Bank Nifty is also concerned. And if you speak about the mid-cap and the small-cap indices, both are seeing gains of close to only about 0.5%. That's about the market snapshot in the run-up to expiry, but let's move on and focus on banks now. Banks, NBFCs and microfinance names have seen a major impact of the demonetization drive, for it increased the fears of rising NPAs. The buffer for the economy and operations to normalize post the announcement is nearly over. What does the road to recovery, especially for micro lenders, look like? Joining us to shed more light on this is Mr. H.P. Singh. He's Chairman and Managing Director at Satin Credit Care. Good morning, Mr. Singh. Pleasure to have you on the show. Let's start off with how the recovery is panning out, especially in terms of repayments, if you can take us through that. I mean, in terms of cash collections, is there some easing off that has been seen after 40, 50 days of demonetization?
Yes, there's been a constant recovery if you look at week after week since the demonetization has happened. So if I take you down from the first week onwards, I think first week onwards our collection efficiency all across the sector was close to about 20-25%, which till our last week, in fact, you know, which probably will be closing in by tomorrow or as such. But the current week now shows a collection efficiency of close to about 85% to about 90% all across. Certain pockets definitely, yes, have still, because of the liquidity crunch and because of the supply side issues of the currency still not being able to reach in that flow, will have a slight lag. But I think, you know, if you look at the percentages as such, you know, this is probably been now closer to, I won't say near normal as such, but I think it's getting closer to real normals as such.
Right. Mr. Singh, you say that the collection efficiency is ruling at levels of 85 to 90%. Break it down for us and explain to us on the ground as to how do these collections are actually undertaken, because these are cash collections, as you say, happen on a weekly basis. Tell us a couple of things. Are there any centers which are quote-unquote zero collection centers? I mean, where you've seen absolutely no cash recollections from that period. Is there a certain number associated with that? And also, what happens when the payments are delayed by, say, a month? I mean, does that dent some kind of recovery given the time duration as well?
So I think a couple of things which have happened. I think, you know, RBI is... Reserve Bank of India has given an asset reclassification for which was earlier given for 60 days, has now increased to about 90 days. So that gives us some kind of a breather where we are able to take stock of the situation as technically looking forward. So the NPS will not probably be there to that large extent because of reclassification and that moratorium of reclassification which is going to happen. The other thing, I think, you know, if you really look at it, when we started as such, probably centers which were to go through for collection, zero center collections were probably maybe at about 60% or so. which has now considerably dropped down to centers where probably no collection has come in, is below 5%. You know, so if you look at that trend of no centers coming in for collection, definitely it's a very healthy figure where probably which is dropped down below 5% as such. You know, so this is closer to about 3-4%, which will definitely, as the supply side eases off, will probably get down to near normalcy in terms of collection for centers as such.
Right. Mr. Singh, that number is interesting. I mean, you say that it's come down from around 60 to 5%. So that's come down at a very sharp clip. And this has happened within these 50 days. Can you tell us in terms of the recognition norms, say, suppose there's a repayment of the microcredit that has been extended and it comes back within, I mean, say on the 78th day or the 80th day, but before the 90 days, you still will not obviously recognize that as a delinquent asset or a non-performing or a bad asset, even if the first repayment is made within those 90 days, that will cut it, is it?
Yeah. So it is that. So it's basically taking it 90 days forward. So technically something which was due in November, let's say the second week as such, and doesn't come there for 90 days, technically that phase will extend beyond that to another 90 days. So we have that grace period where we will be able to, if we do the collection technically, it will not lead to an NPA. Before earlier, if you go by the earlier classification, within 90 days it would have reached an NPA level. So we practically get about 90 plus 90 days more to get that recovery before it gets into an NPA.
Oh, so is it 180 days?
We'll technically get into 180 days. Exactly.
Okay. And the recognition of that NPA happens if it breaches those 180 days?
Breaches that 180 days, exactly.
Fair enough. All right. Let's speak about, UP will be having elections in some time. You've got centers in UP as well. At a time like this, there are a lot of SOPs that are announced by the local government, even the competing political party, to woo vote banks. And a lot of this lies in clusters where you are also extending loans. Are you seeing any problems of moral hazard or the idea of not returning or repaying loans in terms of microcredit? Is there a problem in the state of UP that you have faced in certain pockets at all?
I think we had an initial phase right after demonetization where I think that rumor, once the RBI circular had come in, I think it sparked off a rumor where the dispensation was taken as a loan moratorium going forward. So that's been cleared now. And I think, you know, the initial phase or the initial rumors of loan waivers and everything which was there earlier associated with even like the state of UP has completely died down. I think, you know, the district administration has been very clear in their role, and they have in fact said that there is no loan waiver as such. You'll have to repay because it's a loan which comes from the organized financial sector. And the other thing, I think, you know, which is there, I think RBI is probably the sole regulator for NBFC MFIs. My sense is, I think, you know, they've got a very major role to play, and definitely I think the state administration, which probably would have happened the way other crisis happened in 2010, I think that's far from over now. So I think, you know, that's practically over now. So even if, you know, SOPs probably would be around for an election state or an UP, it will not be a SOP technically for waiving of commercial loans or maybe loans from NBFC, which is undertaken by the RBI.
Okay. What about disbursements? Can you share with us a number as to how that has reduced, by how much, if at all? And are you allocating the cash repayments to disbursements as well?
Yeah, that's exactly what we are doing, because since we still have specific we are not able to still withdraw according to the way which was being done earlier from our bank accounts, where we have our leverage debts being lying on those bank accounts. So whatever is being collected is being disbursed. So that cycle has started on. So technically, whatever is coming in, as they say, definitely it would not be the pace at which before the demonetization the disbursement would happen. But I think it's picking up as the collection efficiency increases, as the collection amount starts increasing. I think disbursements are also going to rise in that proportion right now. So once this happens, and once we get the withdrawal limits also, maybe we are seeing it after December 30th, there could be some increase in the limits, so where we can actually withdraw, even if it doesn't come to normalcy, but, you know, it probably will be there. But I think, you know, my sense is that, you know, as soon as the withdrawal limits come back to the near normal as such. You know, the disbursement will again take a rise further.
Mr. Singh, also speak to us about cashless collections, because by September 2016, of the overall collections, your cashless collections were almost 22 to 23%, and you said that efforts on integrating IT and tech are ongoing in that area. Is that proportion increasing or targeted to increase, and at what number would it be at this point?
So our cashless collection was happening through one of the service providers, which was ITZ Cash. After the demonetization, I think it's probably been there static at the same percentage. But once this currency supply starts increasing over there, I think, you know, we'll still get back into the cashless mode. What we are adding on besides cashless collection is also how to do cashless disbursement also. So we are tapping into the Aadhaar accounts and the and all these accounts where we can actually, once again, you know, the withdrawal limits get into the final shape as such, we'll disburse into the client's account and their bank account, and definitely then probably, you know, we'll be able to do it. My own sense is in the next 6 to 8 months, we'll probably reach a figure which will be closer to 100%, let's say in about 8 months' time, where we can do cashless disbursements as well as we'll be able to do cashless collections also. So I think it'll start increasing right once the supply again, you know, gets back to normalcy as such.
All right. Mr. Singh, your focus also, I'm assuming, will be on securitization of the portfolio. Till now, I mean, there's greater of debt and lesser of securitization, but the yield is, I suppose, 11.5%. That's quite attractive. Are you finding good traction there? And what's the pipeline in terms of securitization that you have in mind?
Securitization, unfortunately, has taken a slight blow, you know, after the demonetization has happened. My own sense is, again, you know, securitization, because you don't have fresh portfolios, definitely, in that larger scale where securitization can probably happen. But my own sense is, again, I think, you know, the investors who probably do the securitized paper as such, you know, again, waiting for efficiency, collection efficiency to come up to the near normal level as such, and before So until that happens, I think the securitization will be a slight challenge going ahead. But my sense is, you know, November, December has been very lean periods for securitization, but from January onwards, I think it will start picking up.
All right, Mr. Singh, we're going to leave it at that, but appreciate you joining us with a quick view on how the recovery picture is panning out in terms of cash collections and also the focus on cashless collections going ahead from here on, and what geographies are seeing most buoyancy and the outlook going ahead in terms of securitization as well. Well, let's move on now, and in keeping with the theme